There's a chance that when we push that button, we destroy the world.
Chances are near zero.
Near zero.
What do you want from theory alone?
Zero would be nice.
It's such a pleasure to speak to the both of you, gentlemen. I'll start with you, Chris, and diving into this very thought-provoking, fascinating world at the time. What were you mostly driven to?
I was mostly driven to getting the audience into Oppenheimer's head. His story is one of the most dramatic I've ever encountered. And I felt that if we could just, you know, be there with him in these incredible situations, including and not least this moment where he and the other scientists of the Manhattan Project don't quite know, they can't quite eliminate the possibility that when they do that first test, they might destroy the entire world. And yet they go ahead and they push that button, and to be there in that room, to take the audience there, that really was the driving force for me, to sort of sit in his head, go through these things with him, and come to understand rather than to judge him.
But I can perform this miracle.
World War II would be over. Our boys would come home.
That's happening, isn't it?
What an extraordinary experience to be part of this film. I mean, I feel it's like an Ivy League kind of film, you know? Everyone's at it, top of its game, no?
Oh. Yeah, well, we hope sure. So. We're trying to match.
Everyone except for Blunty over here.
No?
Oh, well,
come on now. Come on. I know you've been stuck with me all day, but you've got to keep being generous and saying nice things.
Sorry,
right?
Sorry.
We're all trying to kind of amount to the giant that Chris Nolan is on the genius front and on the just being good front, but... Yeah, it was an immense, cool journey for all of us, an exciting one, and I'm so happy it's out. It's really cool.
Truman needs to know what's next.
Two.
What's next?
One.
How do you dive into those people's lives? Because they were public figures, and by nature, when you're a public figure, there's little known about you privately.
Sure, well, I mean, obviously, there's a wealth of information for certain of the characters. Killian had a trove of stuff to dig through. The character I played, Louis Strauss, was a little bit more, I want to say, buried by history. But again, Chris was certainly not asking us to imitate in any way, because then that becomes the preoccupation, rather than just letting the truth kind of find you as you go in this very exacting environment.
They won't fear it until they understand it. And they won't understand it until they've used it.
Being audience members on these types of films, is it the total kind of film you want to be in a cinema, seated down, and you guys as audience members just rediscovering from another viewpoint?
Yeah, you want to find the biggest screen that's showing this movie, without question.
Because that's what it was made for, and Chris sweat bullets for this, and for it to be a fully immersive experience. And he made it because he loves audiences, and he wants you to feel it. He wants you to feel this movie shuddering through your veins. That's what he wants. And he's just so pleased. Like, go to the biggest screen you can find. And I think that's what I saw it on. I haven't seen it with an audience.